Hello, welcome, Cavage here. So we got the Recollections of Dusk for Lars with the new changes to the game mode, and I am not happy. The thumbnail reads, developers, change it back. I was thinking about doing this video all in Japanese, hoping that it would reach the developers, but I watched JP YouTuber's Yukito livestream playing the mode last night, and the comments were full of people saying what I was going to say anyway, so I feel there's enough backlash that I don't need to make the video myself. I'll just settle for the thumbnail. For the record, Recollections of Dusk is still extremely worth doing. The stories are some of the best in the game, and all the characters, weapons, and debris are very usable in all game modes at the highest levels. But with the changes, it's no longer fun to play the RD quests. And to address the biggest barrier to entry, the time and effort needed to build all the teams, the developers upgraded the auto team build function, but it's still nearly useless, so if you didn't like the team building before, you still won't like it now. I've always been conflicted on my feelings on the RD quests. I feel like they should be as approachable as possible because the stories are attached to the mode. We want as many users as possible to see the stories. But I selfishly enjoy the difficult boss fights and the weird teams with underrated costumes I could get clears with. Those were things that I could enjoy only with a very developed account and a more hardcore gameplay mindset. With these Lars RD quests, the overall difficulty is lower. I full autoed the whole thing with random memoirs, and there is less need for a developed account weapons-wise, so that lowers the bar to entry. But it doesn't satisfy gameplay-wise. If the developer's goal was just to get players through the mode ASAP, mission accomplished, I guess, but they sacrificed the fun along the way. Except, along with all the other changes, they added a character element restriction, light costumes only. I was able to full auto it because I have a developed light account with a number of top tier light attackers like RD Gale, FF Noel, FF Udeal. But what about folks without them, or Anniversary Sarafa, or Anniversary Gale, etc.? And then, in the future very hard quests with 5 doors, we'll need 15 light costumes, possibly 5 top tier attackers. That raises the bar to entry, so what really is the aim of these changes? It feels very conflicted or directionless or not thought through. One of the little joys I got in the game was to use my beloved underrated costumes like Abstract Demis or Abstract 063Y or DM Noel in all the RD quests, but this time I can't. I ended up using a very small selection of costumes, and I used a lot of the same teams across different difficulties. You might be thinking, but future RD quests will come with different elements, you can use your favorite costumes then. Alright, but when is that going to be? 2 months from now, 4 months from now, 6 months. I might be okay with the element limitation if they really sped up the release pace of RD quests, like one character a month, including very hard. And part of why I'm okay with element restrictions in Tower and Fate boards is because they have or had quick release schedules, and they just focused on weapons, but that seems very unlikely for RD quests. I don't know. A lot of the design decisions this year give me pause. It feels like the developers don't have a grand plan. They're just doing random things because they feel the pressure to do something. Fragments, what do they add to the game? Aren't they just stat inflation? I don't know. They'll keep users busy, ship it. Aces of the Arena, who is this event for? I don't know. Throw some nice rewards in there, say it's for the community, ship it. Add elements to costumes, doesn't that step on the fun part of team building where you can customize the element of your favorite costumes? I don't know, it's different, ship it. That's what it feels like. I say this in every mobile game I cover, but every system of battle, every system of character leveling, have their natural limits, which are typically bumped up against within the first couple years, and after that it's just rearranging and repackaging what we already have. Like, Fate boards are essentially just Tower 2.0. Level 100 for characters is just stat inflation stapled on to keep us busy in said Tower 2.0. I don't love stuff like this, but I resign myself to it. It's just a reality in mobile gaming because users always want something new, and the developers can only work within a design space limited by the original battle system and leveling system. But to pull the teeth out of a game mode I enjoy, like Recollections of Dusk, is where I draw the line. Change it back, developers. And while I have your ears, bring back the original Arena Showdown and give us true generic Awakening Stones. Alright. But to end on a positive note, I do want to do a batch review of the RD costumes and weapons and debris. They really are great, especially for free-to-play users, and even if it's no longer fun to get them, they are very worth the effort, and it'll give me a chance to talk about Lars, which I didn't get to in this video. Okay, thanks for watching, and we'll see you again. Take care.